Welcome back to The Witcher 3. We've just been told by Radovid where Whoreson Jr. is hiding out. And apparently he's hiding out in a mansion right here. So, let's go say hello to Whoreson Jr. Also, this weather's depressing as hell. We'll see if tomorrow's a sunnier day. Partially overcast, but not bad.
Your kind spreads disease. Defeat
is
under
Witcher?
They found another
Ooh, you know what? There's actually a board over here with some quests, or at least possible quests. Let's go check it out.
Got anything for an aching belly? Stabbing pain under my belt since yesterday.
Yoink. Marker, new quest. Truth is in the stars. Two new quests. Three new quests. Contract the Oxenfurt drunk. Somebody put out a contract on a drunkard? God, Gwen. Oh my god, there's so many freaking quests. I'm overwhelmed. I was just gonna go visit Whoreson Jr., but now I've got a million quests. And oh my god, there's even more. And also, I feel like it's time for some new hair, don't you?
Greetings, Master. What can I do for you?
Got a razor and shears? Good. Make me look decent.
You do yourself a disservice, Geralt, implying you're not already decent. I like the hair. But, let's see what the other ones look like. Shaved on the sides, short on top, and a ponytail. Yeah, sure. Careful with the razor. That's pretty cool looking, I like it. Let's change the beard, too. Friendly mutton chops, as opposed to angry mutton chops. How do you tell the demeanor of mutton chops? You know, it doesn't cost much money. Let's just see what the mutton chops look like. God, no. This does not fit my image of Geralt. Let's see what the mustache and the soul patch looks like. You know what? How about we just go back to how we were before? Yes, use that razor. To put hair back on my face. Yeah. I swear that looks a little bit different than how it was before, though. But, whatever.
So long.
It's really cool looking. Yeah, look at that. And my new clothes look so fancy. I love the colors on them. Orange and reddish. Pants are like a light blue. I think I look quite dashing.
Whores only ever got. What do you want?
Where's Whoreson Jr.?
Oh, this one's got bollocks, don't he? I know you, you motherfucker. Saw you kill Olgard and Vic.
And now I've come for you. You want to fight? Let's fight.
Believe I did have the pleasure to meet those two gentlemen. What were the names again? Olgard and Vic? Give them my regards.
That guy's gonna get a good hit on me as soon as I close out of the menu. I just want to make sure I've got oils on the appropriate blades. Yep.
Take it from the back!
I got two keys. Anybody else want my extra? I'll leave it under the rock here. Oh, he's got arrows. No, you don't. No, you don't. No arrows allowed. Anyone else have arrows? Come on. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay. Hold on, this calls for some bombs. That is seriously disgusting. Just a pile of bodies and blood and gore and disemboweled stomachs. All on the stairs. At least I look stylish doing it. I'm sorry, but that looks fucking ridiculous. Look at that. I mean, I know that's the lower half of the person's body, so it's kind of disgusting, but, like, legs don't stretch like that, and they're also pure red. Oh, you know what? I take that back. They're actually not pure red. If you notice the very tip of their left shoe, there on the right side of the screen, if you notice the very tip of their left shoe, there's a little patch that the blood hasn't quite soaked into. So I don't want to paint with too wide of a red brush. They're not completely red. I see more on the minimap. Ooh, lots of arrows. You know, might want to take out your sword. Oh, they put away their bows. Once again, completely stretched legs, completely red. Or almost red. I think there's another little patch that's not quite red. Let's kill these people while my thunderbolt's still going. Let's not go into the basement just yet. Okay, now let's go into the basement. That looks like it can be broken. Aha. What have you got down here? Is this where he's hiding out? I think I've got some cat, don't I? There it is. Oh, no, I forgot, how do you drink? Right click? No. E. Oh, it's locked. I guess maybe that was an alternative entrance to get into the mansion. God, now everything's just disgustingly bright up here. Let's just meditate that away, shall we? There we go. What the
fucking degenerate? He so much as touched Siri, he'll pay.
What in the hell has he been doing up here? Is she dead? I don't see her breathing. I don't see any blood around her, though. Other than, I mean, there's all this blood on the fucking floor, but... Oh, fuck. Are you dead? Oh, yeah, shit. She's being held up with knives in her palms, I just realized.
Nailed it to the wall.
Jesus Christ. This guy's seriously sick. What the fuck?
Sandwich fuck is this? No, fuck me. Help me for fuck's sake.
No one's coming. Hello, Junior. I've come to talk.
I'll do whatever you want.
Got a few questions to start with.
I'll tell you everything.
I'm looking for a young woman and a minstrel. I know you've met them.
A bird? What fucking...
Ashen-haired with a sword on her back, just like me.
Yeah, yeah. That was... I remember.
Pay attention now. You'll tell the truth. Want to know why?
I won't lie. Honest.
Took me a long time to find you. wasn't an easy road to travel. I'm angry and tired. Had to kill a lot of people along the way. Some of them tried to cheat me. Some tried to lie. I didn't like it one bit. I feel like one more lie'd be the last bitter drop in a chalice full of sorrow. And then I'd do something I would later regret. Now you know why you can't lie to me?
Yes.
Good.
The last bitter drop in a chalice full of sorrow? Really, Geralt? This is such a serious situation, I'm not sure whether to laugh or not about that. It just sounds ridiculous, though. Laying it on a bit thick, Geralt.
I'd like to know how the ashen-haired woman ended up meeting you, and what happened to her.
What happened to her? She attacked me!
Lie one more time, and I'll cut your balls off.
We'd made a deal. I was to repair their magic filler, what's it? That girl and the songster were to bring me Siggy Reuven's treasure. They didn't, so I might have flown off the handle a bit, I admit.
What did you do?
I nabbed their flunky, Dodo, and waited for them to come for him. Look, this. Here's what they wanted fixed.
A phylactery? You can fix something like this?
Not me. I know a guy.
Wasting my time, Junior. I need details.
I'll tell you all. Just the way it happened.
Got a bad feeling about this.
Calm down, Dandelion. I can't leave Dudu in Whoreson Jr.'s hands, you know that.
I know, but my gut can't be reasoned with, and no amount of sympathy I feel can silence it, blot it out.
I'll go in alone, you know? You'll stay outside.
I can't let you go alone. Anything happens to you, Daryl will rip my head off.
Someone must secure our retreat. There's bound to be a struggle. Things could get intense. We'll need to flee fast. Disappear in the crowd. Have you learned where Whoreson is keeping Dudu?
Room on the top floor. One with the balcony.
I'll need to cross onto the roof. Wait for me in front of Junior's house. And I know it's difficult, but do try to look inconspicuous.
If they hurt you, Whoreson will pay.
I must climb onto the roof.
Ah, sweet, I get to play as Ciri again. It's been a while. And I'm pretty sure Dandelion has an entire fortune on his person in clothes and jewels. My god, that outfit. I want to get into combat right now as Ciri so I can do the teleport move.
Room on the top floor. One with the balcony. There's the balcony. Let's see what's inside.
And now, my dear Dodo, I believe I'll try a different tool. Afraid I'm bored with this one.
You're fucking balmy, Junior! Anyone tell you that?
No. Most say I'm nice. Once they get to know me.
So you enjoy good company? Like to make new acquaintances?
You plan to introduce me to someone interesting? There you are. Good of you to come. I've been waiting for you.
Well, we know the outcome of this fight, right? Obviously, they don't die. Because I'm talking to them right now, in the future.
Where's Reuven's treasure?
Oh. Each time Ciri uses her special powers, her energy declines. Some energy is restored each time you attack a foe. Oh, is this new? I don't remember having an energy bar for teleport.
I've got you, you little hole. Where's Ruby's treasure? I've got you, little hole.
I love this teleport, it's so cool.
An eye for an eye.
They're coming.
Dudu, listen. This is what we'll do.
Get that fucking whore!
That's it, you're in for it!
Keep it together, legs!
Open it! Grab the counter!
Dudu is, of course, a Doppler. I'm trying to remember their name. A Doppler, so. Just made themselves to look like that person. Quick thinking. Very quick. Yeah, there he is, still on the ground. Oh shit, I thought it was far enough back. Combat is a lot harder as Ciri. It's very different. Yeah, this is a really bad place to be. Finally got out of there. Not having Geralt's little side hop dodge thing is really just feels debilitating. The teleport is so cool.
That's what happened. Told you true.
Dudu, what happened to him?
I don't fucking know. Prick vanished. There one moment, gone the next.
What happened to the woman?
Fuck if I know. One of the boys got her in the back, but she's alive, I swear it.
Got anything else to say?
I've told you all I know. Everything.
You hurt the woman I'm looking for. You tortured her friend.
She attacked me. I have a right to defend myself. I beg you. Got what I deserved. Have mercy. Please.
Well, I'm talking to this guy in a room where he just murdered, like, 5 women, it seems like. So... nah.
Let me tell you where things stand. I'm looking for this woman, 'cause she's like a daughter to me. And that's why I just can't let this go.
No, no.
Wow, it actually happens off screen. Also, why is my view bobbing? My view's like zooming in and out. I'm not pressing anything. I'm literally not pressing anything. Why is my view doing this? Please stop. Why is it doing this? I'm gonna get sick if it does this for the entire rest of the game. Maybe if I meditate. No, it's still doing it! What the? Okay, I'm gonna be right back. I'm gonna save the game and reload it. There we go. Looks like reloading my saved game stopped the weird view bobbing. Yeah, this guy's a sick fuck. It just... what did he do? Just get a bunch of prostitutes and then, what, had fun with them and then just killed them? What the fuck is wrong with this guy? I'm scared to even see the rest of the house. There are just more bodies. At least there's no bodies over here. Did I loot his body? Does he have a key on him? Because there is a locked door. Can't loot him. Let's make sure I loot everything in case there is a key. Found candy and dumplings, yay! I want to get the hell out of this house. And let's just check and make sure I didn't find a key, but didn't realize it. Let's go try the locked door. Nope, still locked.
Seems you've resolved your matters. It's time you return the favor.
Radovid doesn't like to wait much, does he?
That was quick.
No, he does not. You'll come with us.
That was awfully quick.
The HMS Oxenfurt Tretagor. Once the crown jewel of the Redanian fleet. Decommissioned now, though.
Nice boat.
You'll need to leave your weapons if I'm to let you aboard. Follow me. The ship was funded with donations from noble women. Ladies from the most prominent families gave up their jewelry.
A spur-of-the-moment patriotic impulse?
You're a homeless wanderer. Can't understand what it is to truly love one's country.
This boat looks amazing. It's huge.
There you are.
Need something from me, Your Majesty?
You've never been one to mince words. Very well. Find Philippa Ryleheart. That's my wish. I ordered her eyes gouged out once. But apparently her blindness troubles her not. My hunters have detected Lady Ryleheart hiding east of Oxenfurt. They have further established that she has magically sealed the entrance to her shelter. Entering it will be difficult. I believe you might succeed in doing so. Bring her to me, alive.
Philippa Ryleheart. What's she looking for here?
I suspect she wants to find her old friends. Reconvene the lodge. Perhaps she seeks revenge on me. Lady Ryleheart is known for her persistence. At times I recall the lessons she gave me when I was a child. Her teachings as memorable as the punishment she meted out. She was subtle and patient in her cruelty. I took her sight, but she remains dangerous. I'd advise you to be cautious.
Philip is using magic. You'd be better off sending mages after her.
I agreed to the Conclave's revival, but what has this brought me? The mages at my side are mediocrities, cowards. They couldn't hold a candle to the likes of Ryleheart, Loanteal, or Merigold.
There's always your witch hunters.
You are the best witch hunter. You've proven it clearly. Sheila de Tanzerville and Philippa Ryleheart's plan. You were the one to foil it. I want you to finish what you started. Now go to the mountains and bring me Philippa Ryleheart.
I think I'm just gonna put that quest on the back burner and not do it for a while.
Your arms.
Thanks.
Never seen better steel in my life. Blade must strike true, no?
It's a matter of the hand, not the steel it's holding.
That's Geralt saying, you just suck at swords.
Pardon me, Witcher Geralt? Of Rivia?
Yes?
Yeah, what do you want?
I have a message. For you.
Hang on. Who from?
Read it. You'll know.
Perfumed letter. New quest. I've got like a freaking bajillion quests now, Jesus Christ. We need to talk soon. It's important. TM. Oh, that's gotta be Triss Marigold. Okay.
Sent by Triss. Must have been. I should find her.
Alright, let's see what's going on with our quests now. I've gotten so many. So I still want to stay on the main quest and make sure I don't out-level everything. Like, this is level 11. Like, I really need to do this. Yeah, let's go ahead and do that. It's so low level. I want to get it out of the way. Let's do some fast traveling.
Fuck.
What are you doing with that sword, boy? Look at that floating sword. Beautiful. Beautiful. I can scare the laws of physics away. Ooh, downstairs.
Back again, Rivian Trap.
You seem like a prick. Can I talk to you?
Yes?
Count Kurt Dysart?
Are you here regarding the contract?
Wanted to hire a Witcher, didn't you?
I did, but not just any vagabond. One hears all manner of stories about the lunatics of the School of the Cat. Which do you belong to?
Apparently I have a quest for this guy. I didn't even realize that. Yeah, so, ironically, I actually kind of want to be from the School of the Cat, because I want to be more of an assassin-y type of Witcher, with light armor and critical hits and stuff like that. But a lot of people have a problem with the School of Cats, because as we've heard from before, apparently some of them have turned into kind of assassins for hires. So, they don't exactly have the best reputation.
School of the Wolf.
Ah, yeah, a good one. I knew a Witcher of this school. Barnabas? Though his name did begin with a B. Never mind. To the matter at hand. Not long past, I acquired an estate east of Novigrad. I got it on the cheap, you see. The seller was very keen to be rid of it. Now, I've learned, the building is said to be haunted.
Goes to explain the seller's urgency.
I do not believe in ghosts. It is that simple. But my men say the house shakes at night. Walls crumble. Why, even the floors move about.
Is there anything to be done? A remedy for this?
Yeah, pour some salt on the ground, say a couple words. Here, I've written it down on a piece of paper. Just leave me alone. I mean, what? Okay, sure.
Let's talk about my reward first.
I beg your pardon? Asking for coin already, but you've not done the job.
Need to make sure it's worth my time.
Just look at that. Arrives in Novigrad and he's off his head in minutes. Very well. How much do you believe this should cost me?
I want your coat. Nah, I can't ask for that. I want all your 350. Give me all your money.
Ha ha! That was rich! I could hire 3 witches for that amount. Now that you've had your jest, how much?
300.
No, I'm afraid that's too much.
Just give me the job!
Yes, agreed.
Fine. I'm willing to investigate. How do I get there?
An orchard adjoins the property. The house itself you should recognize easily. Cracks cover its walls. Here's the key. And good luck.
No, I actually...
You lumpen proletarian!
What? No, I do actually want to do that quest. I think the haunted house quests are always so fun.
Think I know how to free Dandelion. Got a plan. But we need Dudu. Gotta find him.
This plan? What is it?
Our Doppler friend will assume Menga's form. Order Dandelion move to Oxenfurt. We can grab him on the way.
Brilliant. But how do you aim to find Dudu?
You're his friend. Any idea where he might be hiding?
With the Doppler, the question's never where, but as whom? In the past, facing trouble, he'd disappear, then reappear on the morrow with someone else. But this time he hasn't returned.
You know what I just, thought of? Something I'm really curious about. Dopplers. Do they have an original form? You know what I mean? Is there a base form? Is it possible for a Doppler to turn into itself, or does itself not even exist? I mean, when a Doppler is born or comes into being, however Dopplers are made, what's their first form? Do they have a natural state? I wonder.
Known Dudu long?
I know this might sound strange, but I can't be sure. It seems he'd been circling me for some time in various forms, trying to attract my attention.
Can't blame him for making the effort.
Thank you. I failed to notice him at first. Then he decided to shoot the moon, assumed Dandelion's form.
What tipped you off? How'd you know it wasn't Dandelion? Dudu not much of a singer?
No. He simply spoke about something other than himself.
We need to convince Dudu to reveal himself. Any friends we could leave a message with, someone he trusts?
Dandelion? Irina Renard's troop, that's all really. Not certain he was friendly with anyone else. Spent dawn till dusk with the troop, on stage or in the crowd.
So he liked going to the mummings?
Yes. I'm actually surprised he didn't come to us after it all happened. He certainly could have counted on the Foxen's help.
So if these mummers are ready to help...
We need only mention Dudu. Irina and company are deeply indebted to him.
Dudu and the mummers, how'd they meet?
That was my doing. Some opening night. Maxim lay comatose in his wardrobe, drunk as a otter. I thought of Dudu. Hard to imagine a better actor than a Doppler.
And Dudu revealed himself to them just like that?
I didn't think it wise to tell anyone. But Dudu and Irina took to each other completely and right away. He fell so hopelessly in love with the theater.
That he started performing with you?
Yeah. Now Irina feels terribly guilty. They let him put himself in danger. She can't forgive herself.
Yeah, Dopplers would make amazing actors, right? I mean, you could have them play any role. The only limit is that they can only play one role at one time, but they could play anybody. It would save you a lot on hiring actors.
Maybe we could use a play. You know, work a message to Dudu into something. Lure him out of hiding that way.
Not a bad idea, but I doubt a few lines would suffice. Besides, do you really think Dudu whiles away his days attending mummings he knows by heart?
So what do you suggest?
We must write an entire new play. From scratch. Something grand. Something that will grab Dudu's attention. So most importantly, it must have a splendid title. It must be the talk of the town. If you wish, we can start on it right away.
I don't think Geralt really has a way with words. I don't think he's much of a writer.
Not sure I'm cut out to write a play. Maybe you're better off doing this on your own.
It's sure to go quicker if you help me. You'll see, we'll have a grand time together.
Okay.
All right. Guess we can start writing the play.
Any ideas for the plot?
Actually, I was hoping.
The key is to convince Dudu that he can rely on you. And that we wish to free Dandelion. The message must be clear, though naturally woven into the play's dramaturgical essence, meaning we need an appropriate dramatic structure. Following along?
Mm-hmm.
More or less.
That'll do. Now to find the proper expressive form for our content. A gripping, contemporary story, that would be best. Perhaps about the condottieri of Povis. I know. Lorenzo Molla. A tale of a handsome but ruthless bandit, and the Doppler who manages to fool him. But now the Doppler must hide, and can only count on the help of his friend, who's a witcher, who in turn is prepared to do anything to save his better. His beloved. What do you think?
Sounds perfect.
Sounds great.
Really think so? Lorenzo Molla. Yeah. Or perhaps not. Wait, I've got it! We shall stage a story of the Urchin of Erlenwald. Secret lovers, their betrothal, a curse, a cruel queen, bell sounding midnight.
But...
At which point he reveals his face. He's a monster, there to steal Princess Palvetta. they want him dead, but at that instant, a Witcher steps in. And everything ends splendidly. So it's settled, yeah? You wish to say something?
Why did she want me here again? I can't write a play, and she's not even listening to me.
We need a good title. Venture to say that's more important than the story itself.
I have some ideas. Perhaps you can choose.
Gonna consider my opinion this time?
Of course. We're partners in this. I'm just in charge. I've two really good ones. The Doppler's Salvation and A Changeling Rescued or The Witch's Triumph. Which do you prefer?
A Changeling Rescued or The Witch's Triumph. The Doppler's Salvation. Let's go with the Doppler Salvation.
Let's go with the Doppler Salvation. It's shorter, catchier. Just one problem. No Dopplers in that story. Just a princess and a cursed urchin.
Nothing simpler. We need merely swap the Doppler in for the urchin. The message, that's what's important. A Witcher arrives and saves the Doppler. Got it?
All right. So it's a comedy.
I was thinking more along dramatic lines. If you prefer something lighter. Listen, merely decide and I'll get to work.
My god. I can actually choose whether it's a drama or a comedy. Let's go with drama.
You're right. A drama'd be better.
Very well. I must get to work. While you must pick a corner, sit down, read silently, or just think. All right?
Fine, since you don't need help with the writing.
Geralt, wait. A rhyme for Witcher?
Did Itcher?
Ugh. Just keep quiet. Done. I could make a small masterpiece of this had I a bit more time, but...
We're fresh out of that. The hidden message to Dudu. What did you weave in?
Hidden message?
You were gonna work something in, like... Come to the Kingfisher at dawn, or...
That wouldn't be in keeping with the tone of the play, not at all!
You wrote it to contact Dudu. That was the purpose. Fine. So how do you see this working?
I don't know. I was counting on recognizing him by his scar. Or just improvising. Shall we worry about that later? First, you must take the script to Madame Irina. Sure you know where to find her? The troupe performs in the butcher's yard off the main square.
Join us later. See ya.
Oh, I'm so close to leveling up, I think. Yeah, look at that. I don't even need 100 XP to get to the next level, and I believe when I get to the next level I can use my new sword, right? Didn't I craft one? Didn't I craft one? Or am I wearing it already? I thought I crafted one. Did I not? Oh, here it is. Yeah, level 17. Oh right, the red X, that means... At first I thought that meant it was broken. No, that just means you can't use it. See, as soon as I level up I can use this beautiful thing. So many sockets. 3 sockets. 50% critical hit damage bonus, oh my god. I'm gonna do so much damage with critical hits, it's gonna be obscene. It's gonna be a beautiful thing. Alright, well, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, I'm gonna take the script to Irina.